Well, another first in broadcast history. This is Alaska Matters. I'm Christopher Story for Great Adventure. I'm your host for Great Adventures in the Last Frontier. What's got me a little bit distracted today, I'll just share it with you as though you were sitting here in the broadcast studios at the corner of West Hill and the Sterling Highway, the nerve center of Story Productions and the home of the Story Team. That's right. Today, you'll hear gas sounds, the sounds of gas. However, these will be emanating from outside the broadcast studio, courtesy of NSTAR. That's right, we're having a trunk line installed within about 12 feet of where I'm sitting here, and I'm looking out at one, two, three, probably a half a dozen workers working very hard, two small excavators. Now, should the power go out at some point, this is simply for the fact that they've raised the boom of their excavator into the power lines. So I hope that that doesn't happen. However, if it does, because it's dangerously close thus far, I will let you know. We'll move immediately to the mobile broadcast facility, which is never far from my reach, and we'll just continue as though nothing were happening, and I'll report on the ground as to the number of injuries, etc. Hopefully there won't be any. I believe that this group is organized and working very efficiently and professionally. If, however, it turns out to be the other way around, I'll report on it, because that's what we do at KGTL. Accused killer was released from jail just hours before slayings. I'm disgusted. How do you even start talking about something like this? How do you even begin to think about the horrific murder that took place in Anchorage over the weekend? This slime ball, sleaze bag, disgusting excuse for a human being. And I apologize for using that many adjectives in one, you know, poorly crafted sentence, can be released, and he was a pedophile. He is a pedophile. Was picked up on a probation charge, then released after having served his time for the probation. Why was he ever released to begin with? Let me just put it this way. In my world, when I'm king, you touch a child, you die. That's it, pure and simple. Why in the world do we have a system that allows these types of predators to go free? And then he turns around, bludgeons this elderly couple to death, and assaults another child, and then escapes from... Oh, man, let me just tell you something. What happens behind the cells? If I was a guard, let me just say, earplugs would go in, and I see nothing, hear nothing, and have at him, boys. This is just, it's sad. It's horrific. My heart broke when I heard the story first and then read more details about it. And it's heartbreaking. We need to have a real serious discussion with ourselves. Where are we going? What kind of weak, limp society have we become where this type of trash is allowed to be released from jail? We've got to really take a hard look at ourselves and say, is this the kind of society we...
We just don't have room for them all.
I tell you where we've got room. 6 feet under. That's where the room is. There's plenty of it. I think there's a lot of people that would make room in their own on their own property for this kind of... It's just awful. I don't even know what to say about it, other than I just had to vent and say... Oh, my Lord, my heart is breaking for the family, and a man tried to open a door on a flight to Oregon. Okay, I'm a profiler. I profile when I get on a plane. It's what I do. I'm sitting there. I'm profiling you in the airport. You just need to know it. If you and I are sitting at gate GB together, understand that I've analyzed you. I've looked you up and down. I've questioned I profile. I want to know what you're thinking. I want to know why you're going where you're going. I want to know what you're doing when you get on the plane. Have you had too much to drink? Why haven't you had anything to drink? What are you drinking? Where are you going? What are you doing? What are your intentions? This is just me. And I'm trying to relax when I fly. And then I read this. How can I relax? How can I put in my headset, take a couple of, what do I like to take? I like to take Benadryl. Sometimes I'll take two or three Benadryl. Just calms the nerves, you know, just evens the keel a little bit. How can I do that knowing that there could be a 24, 23, 2, anybody could get up and try to release the exit door 10,000 feet as we're descending into Portland or anywhere else? Man, what a hero. The guy jumps up and he puts the guy into a chokehold, takes him down. My fear, and this is just a personal fear, is that I wouldn't have been able to stop restraining him. You know what I'm saying? I mean, they would have had to pull me off of him and restrain me from restraining him. That's just, oh man, thank God that there was people paying attention and willing to stand up and do the right thing. So a hero on board Alaska Airlines. Glen Highway reopens after a 9-car accident. This morning, 6:30 in the morning, it was reported. 9-car accident on the Glen Highway. Here's my guess. I don't know the details. It's still breaking, but here's my guess. Distracted driver. Do you know how many of you I see, and you see them as well, looking down, that telltale looking down at the screen while driving straight ahead at their little handheld smartphone? Man, it's constant. I will admit, I have done it myself, and I'm weaning myself from looking at that text message that just came in. If you got to look at the text message, pull over. Hand it to somebody in the passenger seat. We've got to start paying more attention. 9-car accident. That's awful. Just awful. Today on Alaska Matters, aside from just venting about the news, what I want to do is break into a conversation about GMOs. GMOs, genetically modified organisms. There was a march against Monsanto over the weekend here in Homer and around the world, really. And I don't like, I'm an individual. I rail against collectivism and I propel you and I towards individualism. We've got to celebrate our individuality. We, by our very nature as individuals, you and me, we don't group, you know, we don't get together and march. We don't do these kinds of things. I think 2010 was the birthplace of, you know, the Tea Party and so forth is against the Affordable Care Act. But, you know, where are they now? You don't hear much from those guys anymore. And of course, we're individuals. We disband. We go back to our work. We go back to producing, making things. Well, GMOs, I didn't participate in the rally. I did get to preview the Genetic Roulette movie that played at the Homer Theater on Saturday, sort of as a finale to this March Against Monsanto. It's frightening. It's scary. I want to go inside the mind of a critical thinker, Fred Cates, today, who's studied up on the subject, and he'll be on the program to share his thoughts on GMOs, why you should be concerned, and, well, whether you should be concerned or not. I'm assuming that he's got a take on that you should be. Our Alaskan Mindbender brought to us by Blackwater Bend, your opportunity to win a free coffee card at Blackwater Bend Espresso. Anchor River Inn jumps in as a new sponsor of Alaska Matters, and we'll talk a little bit about the Anchor River Inn in Anchor River, of course, at the Anchor Point. That's aptly named. Jonathan Walker here to introduce a new segment we're calling Rethink. He's going to give us an opportunity to rethink what we maybe thought we knew. That's in the second half of the program. And Karen Marks will take us out and about. Don't go anywhere. We'll have so much more to come here on Alaska Matters.